Hello everyone, and welcome to our demonstration of NAV 2013, where we introduce you to some of the highlights of the new NAV offering, which includes some great new functionality related to assemblies. Assemblies replaces the old 2009 concept of kits. This is a very top-level view where we will show the changes on the item card related to assemblies, and then take you through a sales order, and finally we'll view an assembly order. Our demonstration is going to start on the item card. NAV 2009 used the term kits, where a kit was identified by having a kit BOM number and the replenishment system would be set to production order. In NAV 2013, if we look at the replenishment tab, we can see that our replenishment system is set to assembly. So this will be an item that we will assemble. Furthermore, if I go down to the bottom of the replenishment tab, I have a new field called assembly policy. If I drill down and look at the options, assemble to stock is essentially an item that will be assembled for us to keep in stock. That way I'll have available quantity on hand at all times. And assemble to order means that the customer will actually call in and place an order for that item, and we'll assemble it at that time. Additionally, if I go to the general fast tab, I can see that an assembly BOM has been assigned. If I drill down, I can see the details of that BOM. Additionally, I can go to the Navigate ribbon and select Assembly and Assembly BOM. And here's where I'll set up the details of this particular BOM. I can see that I have four items that go along with this BOM. And each item has my quantity per, which will be removed from inventory when I assemble this item. I'll click OK. And from here, we're going to go and view a sales order. So I'm going to come out to my sales order home tab and bring up a brand new sales order. We're going to make this sale to the Canon group. And the dates are going to default to today, and our external document number is going to be filled in so we receive no error messages. We'll go down to the type and fill in item. And then we'll fill in our item that relates to our sales order. Assembly item. From here I'm going to put in a quantity of 2, and if you notice that pop-up screen, that shows the attachment of the assembly order in the background. And by filling in a quantity of 2, our quantity to assemble to order was also populated with 2. The results of this are, if I go to the Navigate tab, I can view my assembly order that was attached in the background. And for this particular item, I'm assembling 2, and if I scroll down and look at the lines, I can see the details that make up that assembly BOM. I have 4 different items and a resource that's going to be included in putting this together. My quantity per multiplied by my quantity gives us the quantity to consume. So these will be the quantities that get consumed of each item. When I close this window, I can go ahead and post this sales order. The sales order and the assembly order are both posted at the same time. So now I'm going to go and view the actual item card, 470061. And if I go to my Navigate tab and scroll down into my ledger entries, I can go to the bottom and view that I've assembled a quantity of 2, and I've subsequently sold that 2 as well. So I have the output and the sale both assembled at the same time. That concludes the sales order process. So now if we go and we want to process an actual assembly order, I'm going to do a search for assembly orders. And I'm going to create a brand new assembly order for the Contasso conference system. And in this example, I'm going to assemble 3. So once we get past our date warning message, I can scroll down now and see that the items for that particular assembly BOM have been populated onto my lines. The quantity per is going to be again showing the quantity that's required for each item. So for the Antwerp conference table, I need 5. And to assemble 3, that means I'm going to have to consume 15. So the item to consume appears in this column. I can press OK. And now if I want to post that order, I can go back to my home and select post. Now the assembly order has been posted. And if I go actually out to the item card, for this Contasso conference system, I can now see that I have a quantity of 3 in inventory, whereas before I had a quantity of 0. This concludes our brief tutorial of some of the key assembly components. Hope you enjoyed this demonstration, and we'll talk to you soon.